Hi, today we are talking about Bohr's atomic model that was given by Niels Bohr in 1950. Niels Bohr presented its model by a combination of Rutherford's atomic model and Planck's quantum theory. Niels Bohr works on the defects of Rutherford's atomic model. Why Bohr's model? Bohr's model came into existence with the modification of Rutherford's model. Basically, Bohr's atomic model gave us an idea about shells and orbitals. Rutherford explained the nucleus of an atom, and Bohr modified that model into electrons and their energy levels. Bohr theory modified the atomic structure, explaining that electrons move in fixed orbitals or shells. He explained that each orbit or shell has their own fixed energy. Say, for example, the first shell here is K shell. So K shell has its own fixed energy. By moving on, we have second shell here, that is L shell. It has its own energy. Then comes third shell, that is called as M shell. It has its own energy. On fourth, we have N shell, and N shell has its own energy. So in this way, every shell in an atom has its own fixed energy. And this concept was explained by Bohr. Here we have some postulates of Bohr's atomic model. In an atom, electrons revolve around the nucleus, and here the electron have a negative charge and the nucleus have a positive charge, and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus in definite circular paths. Each orbit or shell has a fixed energy, and these circular orbits are known as orbital or shells. The energy of the electron in an orbit is proportional to its distance from the nucleus. The farther the electron is from the nucleus, more energy it has. Say, for example, this electron is present in the shell 3, so it is more far from the nucleus as compared to this electron which is present in shell 2. So this electron has more energy as compared to this one, because the distance of this electron is more from the nucleus as compared to this electron. Then comes the next postulate. The electron revolves only in those orbits for which the angular momentum of the electron is an integral multiple of nh divided by 2 pi. H is a Planck's constant, and its value is 6.626 exponential 34 joule second, which is fixed. Angular momentum of the electron are quantized. What does that mean? It means electron cannot take every value to revolve around the nucleus. Electron will revolve only in those orbit who have angular momentum of 1h upon 2 pi, 2h upon 2 pi, 3h upon 2 pi, and so on. Angular momentum is integral multiple of natural numbers. It means the n here will 2, 3, 4 up to so on. By moving on, electron in its own shell do not gain or loses energy. It loses or gains energy when it jumps from one orbit to the other, until or unless the electron is present in its orbit, its shell, it will not radiate any energy. It means it will not lose any energy, or it is not going to absorb any energy. Light is absorbed when an electron jumps to a higher energy orbit from a lower energy orbit, and light is emitted when an electron falls into a lower energy orbit from a higher energy orbit. Say, for example, this orbit has an energy of 10 joule and this orbit has an energy of 5 joule. Okay, they both have their fixed energies. This electron wants to jump into the higher orbital, it should absorb 5 joule energy. This electron will absorb 5 joule energy in the form of photon, in the form of light. Now say, for example, there is an electron in the higher orbital, and that electron wants to jump into the lower orbital. So of course, it need to emit energy. It need to lose the energy. So it will lose 5 joule energy and will jump from higher orbital to the lower orbital. So this is the concept. When any electron jump from its lower orbital to the higher orbital, it always absorb energy in the form of photon, in the form of light. And whenever an electron jumps from its higher orbital to its lower orbital, it always emits energy in the form of light or in the form of photon. No doubt, Bohr did an amazing job. He gave us idea about orbits and shells. He works on the drawbacks of Rutherford's atomic model, but still there are some defects in Bohr's atomic model. This model stands true for only hydrogen atom or hydrogen-like atoms, single electron species. We all know hydrogen have only one electron. Its atomic number is 1. By moving on, next one we have is helium. Atomic number of helium is 2. It will lose one electron and will act as one electron species. The atomic number of lithium is 3. It will lose 2 electrons and will act as one electron species. The atomic number of beryllium is 4. It will lose 3 electrons and will act as one electron species. After losing electrons, now hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, these all are acting as one electron species. Bohr model is not applicable on multiple electron species. It does not take account into the wave nature of the electron, so it violates the de Broglie hypothesis, because according to de Broglie, the nature of the electron is wave nature. It's not particle nature. Bohr's model also violates the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, because according to Heisenberg uncertainty principle, no microscopic species can show momentum and position at the same time. Electron is also a microscopic species. But according to Bohr, he explained the momentum and position of the electron at the same time, which is even not possible. Bohr model didn't explain the splitting of spectral lines in electric and magnetic field. Whenever spectral lines passed from the electric or magnetic field, they will deviate. When spectral lines split in an electric field, that is called as Stark effect. When the spectral lines split in the magnetic field, that effect is called as Zeeman effect. So these two effects, Stark effect and Zeeman effect, are not explained by Bohr's atomic model. These all are the defects of Bohr's atomic model that was later on explained by other scientists through other theories and models. So this is all about Bohr's atomic model. Do like, comment, subscribe, and follow this channel for more such videos. Thank you.